Today, inshallah, we are going to finish 3.6 that we have started in the previous class. If you remember, this section is about the derivatives of logarithmic functions. It consists mainly of three parts. What are the derivatives of the logarithmic functions? And we are done with this part in the previous class. Today, we are going to study, inshallah, the method of logarithmic differentiation and see how it will help us to make the differentiation process much easier. And at the end, we will mention how YA can be expressed as a limit, as you can see at the end. So if you remember from the previous class, to summarize what we did in the previous class, we have proved in general that the logarithm B for X, it is 1 over X ln B. And when it is the logarithmic, the natural logarithmic, it is in ln x, then the derivative of ln x, it is 1 over x, because the ln e will be 1. Now, in general, if you have inside ln, if the argument of the ln is another function other than x, then the derivative of ln of g of x will be the derivative of g over g. And this is the same here, by the way, if you notice. It is the derivative of x, which is 1 over x. So it is now by using the chair rule here, the general form of the differentiation. If you have here other than ln, you just write ln b here, if you have another logarithm. Now, we have mentioned these examples in the previous class, if you remember. So you need to combine the derivative of the logarithm with, of course, with the chair rule. So it is just here, it is ln sine x, it will be cosine x over sine x. When you have square root of ln, you need to differentiate the square root first by using the chair rule. Similarly, what we did, I think we have, this was the last example that we have mentioned in the previous class, example number 5. When you have a function, this is not, of course, we need to find the derivative of ln of this function. So this is our function. Of course, this is ln when you differentiate ln g of x, the derivative will be the g prime of x over g of x. This is that what we have learned from before. Now, the question is, you need to differentiate this by using the chair rule or the quotient rule here. So what you will do, you will say that the derivative of this function, it is that just 1 over that function multiplied by its derivative. So let me rephrase it this way. It is 1 over g of x times the derivative of g of x. This is by the chair rule. For simplicity, we put this one here instead of 1. Now, sometimes it is not practical to have it in that complicated form. So it is better to write it 1 over the function multiplied by the derivative of the function. Now, here it is easy. You can just make it as square root of x minus 2 over x plus 1. You know that when you have 1 over a over b, it will be b over a. So it is not difficult. Now, to differentiate this, you need to apply the quotient rule. Just apply the quotient rule. So this is our function multiplied by the derivative of that function by using quotient rule. By the way, if you want, you can apply the product rule. How? It will be the derivative of what? It is the derivative of x plus 1 times x minus 2 to the power negative half. You can apply the product rule in that case, but it's okay. So now, by applying the quotient rule, you will square the denominator. Numerator multiplied by the derivative of the denominator. Now the numerator multiplied by the derivative of square root of x minus 2, which is the derivative of x minus 2 all to the power of half. So its derivative is here. It is a half, the derivative of the power x minus 2 to the power a half minus 1 negative half, multiplied by the derivative of the insider function, which is 1. So this is what we had. We have stopped here. Now, what you will do, this is, by the way, this is multiplied by, now this is the function. Now, if you multiply the numerator by numerator, denominator by denominator, what you will have? This times this will be x minus x plus 1 times x minus 2. Now, if you multiply square root of x minus 2 by square root of x minus 2, it will be x minus 2 times 1, it is x minus 2. Minus a half, this is the half, write it at the beginning, x plus 1. When you multiply x to minus 2 to the power a half by x minus 2 to the power negative half, it will be x minus 2 to the power 0, which is 1. So it's gone. Now expand this, it will be equals to what? X minus a half of x, it will be a half of x. Minus 2, negative 2 minus a half, it will be minus 5 over 2. All over this. Now take a half as a common factor and simplify it, you will get this. This is the much simpler form that you could have for the derivative of this function. By the way, this is solution number one. Believe it or not, there is an easier solution. What is the easier solution? Is to use the logarithm's laws. First of all, before differentiating, write this and using the law of quotient. You know, Shabab, that ln A over B, it is ln, or usually you prefer X and Y. Ln X over Y, it is ln X minus ln Y. And also you know that ln x to the power a, b, or n, or whatever, it is n ln x, not only for ln, for all the other logarithms. So now this will be what? Ln of the numerator minus ln of the denominator, but the denominator is x minus 2 to the power a half, so by using the Bauer's rule, you can put it here. Now, if you want to differentiate now, the derivative is easier because we don't need to use the quotient rule. Look, what will be the derivative? What is the derivative of ln x plus 1? What is it,
Shabab? 1 over x plus 1.
1 over x plus 1. What is the derivative of x plus 1? It is 1. Excellent. Minus a half. What is the derivative of ln x minus 2? It is x minus 2 over the derivative is 1. Look how easy it is. This is the step that you are talking about. Here it is. Now, what you need to do, you need just to write it as a single fraction. You will have this. Write it over one denominator. No need to apply the quotient rule if you use the laws of logarithms. Is that clear, Shabab? Any question about this? So keep in mind the trick of solution number two. Now, you know, Shabab, that the derivative of ln x, the derivative of ln x, is 1 over x. We said that before. Now, this is, of course, this means that x is positive. X here is positive because we cannot have negative inside the ln. So what about the derivative of ln, the absolute value of x? What is it? Is it going to be 1 over the absolute value of x? What do you think? Who has an answer for this question? What is the derivative?
1 over x.
Is it 1 over the absolute value of x?
It doesn't exist.
Does not exist.
1 over x if x is greater than 0, 1 over minus x if it's greater.
Piecewise function.
MashaAllah. Yani this is another option. Is there another ways, ya Shabab, to find the derivative? Believe it or not, the derivative of ln, the absolute value of x, it is 1 over x. But provided that x is not 0. Just like that. So you, if it is positive or negative, if x is positive or negative, its derivative can be positive or negative. It depends on x. Why and how? It is so easy to prove.
Because ln x is from 0 to infinity, right?
X could be any real number other than 0. Only x here cannot be 0. Because it is inside the absolute value. So according to the definition of the absolute value, it is x or negative x. It is x if x is positive, it is x when x is negative. We removed here or equal because x cannot be equal 0 inside the ln, inside any logarithm. Now, this is the function, piecewise function. Now, find the derivative. What will be the derivative? What is the derivative of ln x?
1 over x.
1 over, let me write it here. F of x equals to the derivative, it is 1 over x when x is positive. Now, what will be the derivative of this one?
1 over minus x.
It is
1 over x.
Multiply by minus 1.
Here, we should have the derivative of what?
Minus
1. Minus x, which is
minus 1. What is negative 1 over negative x?
1 over
negative x. Over negative. Positive 1 over x. It is the same. But just x here is positive and x here is negative. This is the only difference. So what we have, we have also here, it is 1 over x and 1 over x. So instead of writing it as two branches, what we can do here, Shabab? It is the same. This one is the same as this. Just here it is greater than 0. Here it is less than 0. To summarize this, we can write it as what?
X not equal to 0.
1 over x. Both of them are 1 over x, but x is not 0. Wala ashal. Here it is. So what we to summarize what we did, the derivative of ln, the absolute value of x, it is 1 over x. And this will lead us taban to saying that the derivative of any function, it will be the derivative of that function over that function. You can show it similarly. Now this will lead us to
what is called the logarithmic differentiation.
What is the logarithmic differentiation? Be careful. Now we have derivative of logarithmic functions. This is something else. We are done with that part. Now we have a method, a new technique to find the derivatives of any function. It is called logarithmic differentiation. Why? Because we will take logarithm of both sides if you have such a problem. Usually, we will use this with the complicated functions. When you have a complicated function that contain products, quotients, powers, and so on, square roots, radicals, use the differentiation or the logarithmic differentiation. What is the logarithmic differentiation? Why we need it? This is what we are going to see now. Look at this function. Please try to use the quotient rule to find it. It will be very long. Try it. So
it's impossible.
No, possible. It is possible, but it will take time, of course. So the best way here is to use the differentiation, the logarithmic differentiation. It is a very easy trick. Take ln of both sides. So this will be ln y equals to ln this. Uh-huh, 3x plus 2 all to the power 5. Now what you will do here, before we didn't differentiate yet. Now, before differentiating, simplify this by using what the logarithms laws. So what will be this? Let me forget about this one. How to simplify this? It will be ln, the numerator, minus ln, the denominator. Am I right?
Yes.
So you will bring this one here and bring that one here. Next, the denominator or the numerator is a product of two functions. So it will be ln x to the power 3 over 4 plus ln the square root of x squared plus 1 minus, this will be ln 3x plus 2 to the power 5. The 5 could be a power. Let me write it here, no problem. 3x plus 2 to the power 5. Now, to the power 5. Now you will apply the power rule. The power rule says that will be 3 over 4 ln x plus this will be a half ln x squared plus 1 minus this will be 5 ln 3x plus 2. Yes, but if you forget the laws of logarithms, no problem. Go and revise the laws of logarithms from 002 or just look at the summary that I gave you at the beginning in lecture number 0. In lecture number 0, you can find the summary of these laws. That's it. Now we simplified the right hand side by using the laws of logarithm. Now this will be very easy to differentiate. To be differentiated, this is easy to differentiate this. So this is exactly what he done, but he did it in one step, Shabab, because he is assuming that you know this from before. He did it all of this work. He did it in one step. So what you will do, this will be 3 over 4x, here, ln x, a half ln x squared plus 1. You can do it, by the way, in one step. And this will be minus, because we have in the denominator, minus 5 ln x. What is all of this? This is ln y. Now, to differentiate this, you need to apply what we have learned before. Let me ask Nawaf al-Umari. Ya Nawaf, help me to differentiate this, Ya Nawaf. What is the derivative of this ln y?
1 over y multiplied by the derivative of y.
Yes, it is y prime over y. Yes, you are right.
Yes.
equals to أحسنت يا نواف 3 over 4 who's next عبد الله سعود عبد الله سعود
1 over x
1 over x طلعت سهلة هي يا عبد الله خلينا نعطيك نعطيك واحدة ثانية يا عبد الله plus a half what is this
2x over x squared plus
1 شوي شوي يا عبد الله علينا لأن احنا فهمنا شوي على قدنا it is x squared plus 1 here in the denominator and here what we have
2x multiply the derivative.
The derivative of the denominator. Thank you, Abdullah. ما شاء الله عليك. عدنان الإبراهيمي عدنان minus five.
Minus five one over اللي هو الجيل x. 3x plus 2 في derivative 3x plus 2 اللي هو 3.
Thank you. Thank you. You are right. Excellent يا شباب. Now this is the y prime over y, but we need يا شباب the derivative of y prime. So how to find y prime? How to find y prime يا تركي تركي حكمي إيش رأيك؟ كيف نجيب ال y prime؟
مرحبا دكتور ال y prime حق وش المعادلة؟
إيه أنا ودي y prime مش y prime على y. كيف أسوي؟ إيش أسوي؟
تضرب في y.
You are right. Yes. Solve it. Solve it for y prime. إذن y prime راح تساوي y مضروب في الكمية هاي اللي هنا كلها. Yes, you are right. والy أنا عارف وش هي. هذه هي. أعوض بدالها بقيمة. Yes, you are right. Totally right. So what is y? هذه هي الy. وهذه طبعا تبسطها 3 over 4x. طبعا you can make this as a single fraction, but no need. Just it is okay like that. You can of course write it over the same LCD. Now, to summarize, these are the three steps of the logarithmic differentiation. If you want to use the logarithmic differentiation, step number one, take the natural logarithm, ln. Take ln. طبعاً, you can use any logarithm, but the ln is the easier because we don't have the other extra terms. So we have ln, use ln for both sides of this equation and use the laws of logarithms to simplify. اللي هي the product rule, product law, will quotient law, will power law. Differentiate implicitly. How to do that, the implicit differentiation with respect to x? This is the step that we are talking about. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. And in the last step, solve the resulting equation for y prime as we did here. Let's have more application about this in the old exam questions. Now, if you remember, ya shabab, we have proved that the derivative of x to the power n, it is n, x to the power n minus 1, for when n is positive integer. We have proved that in 3.1, when we have positive integer. When we have any real number, for example, x to the power square root of 2, the derivative of this, it is square root of 2, x to the power square root of 2 minus 1 also. Why it is true for any real number, not necessarily for integers? We have promised you in 3.1 to prove it in 3.6, and we will prove that now by using with the help of the idea of the logarithmic differentiation. طبعاً, it is important to remember that what is inside the log must be positive. So what we will do, ya shabab, simply, we will put y equals to x to the power n, and we need to differentiate. This is the function. To make sure that it is positive, I will take the absolute value of both sides. And why? Because when I differentiate, طبعا لو حد قايل لك ان y تساوي negative 2, وانت تقول let me take y for both or ln for both sides, this is not true. You cannot take this ln. So when you take ln of both sides, make sure that what is inside is positive. Otherwise, you need to deal with the absolute value. Now, if you take ln for both sides, you can do that because for sure, it will be positive, not zero, of course. Even zero is not accepted. Now, to find the derivative, you will apply the logarithmic differentiation. What is the derivative of this, Shabab?
Y prime over y.
It is y prime over y. We have agreed that the derivative of ln, the absolute value of x, it is 1 over x. So similarly here, this will be what? This will be, طبعاً, n, you will take n here. It will be like this. It will be n ln the absolute value of x. It will be n, the absolute value of x, it is 1 over x. We have proved that before. Now, if you want to apply this to solve it for y prime, you will multiply both sides by y. So it will be y multiplied by n over x. But what is y? y is x to the power n. So this will be what? N, this is n. X over x to the power n over x. It will be x to the power n minus 1. And we have proved this in general. If someone asks you to prove it for the power rule, prove the power rule in general for any power, here, this is the proof. Any question, Shabab? Okay, warning. We have a warning and alert here for you. You should distinguish carefully between the power rule, where the base is variable and the exponent is constant. When you have x to the power 3, the derivative, it is easily 3 to the power x squared. Now, when you have 3 to the power x, this is different here. The base is constant and the power is variable. This is power function. This is exponential. This is power. This is exponential function. So when you have something like this, the derivative of 3 to the power x will be 3 to the power x times ln 3. This is the rule that we have studied before. So be careful when the base is constant, when the base is variable, and so on. Is that clear, Shabab?
Doctor.
Yes.
What if both of them are variables, like x to the power of x?
Good question. Just wait for 1 minute and you will find that answer. Thank you for this question. Now, we will summarize the common mistakes here. Be careful about this, Shabab. What is the derivative of b to the power n? B to the power n, b and n are constant. We are differentiating with respect to what?
To x.
To x. فلا تقول إن الderivative حقت هذه بالنسبة للx هي ln bn minus 1. No. This is constant. There is no x here. No x. So it is constant. Will b والn هما constant. هما functions. They are not functions in x. So here we have what? We have constant base and constant exponent. So in this case, the derivative is zero. Now, the second case, when the base is variable, the base is variable, and the exponent is constant. In this case, we will apply the power rule, like x to the power n. So it will be n times the function to the power n minus 1 times the derivative by the chair rule. The third case, when you have a constant base and variable exponent, constant base and variable exponent. In this case, the derivative will be the same base to the same exponent multiplied by ln b times the derivative of the exponent. Now, the fourth case that you have asked about, when you have a function to the power of function, when a variable x to the power x, for example, a variable to a variable, is the derivative, the question now, when you have x to the power x, is the derivative here with respect to x, is it x times x to the power x minus 1? The answer is no, this is wrong. It is not in general like that. So to do this, when you have a function to the power of function, when you have a variable base and a variable exponent, then you need to use the logarithmic differentiation. What you will do, you will put this equals to y. Y here equals f of x all to the power g of x. Then you will take ln of both sides. So this will be ln this. And when you take this ln, it will be g of x ln f of x. Now to find the derivative, this will be y prime over y equals to, here you will apply the product rule. The first one multiplied by the derivative of the second, plus the second multiplied by the derivative. And this is what you are going to have at the end. I don't advise you to memorize this, no need. But this is the formula in general. Just continue what I did here. So in general, the derivative of a function to the power another function, it will be this way. But no need to memorize this, just apply the logarithmic differentiation. But if you have strong memory and you are sure that you are about, you can use it, why not? Let's apply this with this example. We have here x to the power square root of x. So we have variable in the base and variable in the exponent. How to find the derivative now? we will apply the steps of logarithmic differentiation. Step number one, step number two, step number three. So what we will do in the first step, we will take ln, the natural logarithm of both sides. Then we will simplify. Let's do it one by one, one by one. So we have here y equals x square root of x. We will take ln of both sides. Usually, شباب, in this step, take it two steps in one step, because you need now to go to write it square root of x ln x. Be careful, you can skip this step. You can do it directly. Ln y, bring the power here, ln x. Now to find the derivative, what it will be? It will be y prime over y. Now, what will be the derivative of square root of x ln x? Let me ask someone to help me with that. Let me ask Salim Belharith. Yes, Salim. Yalla, what is the derivative of this, Salim?
We should use the product rule first.
The product rule, yeah, Salim, Ahsant. It is the square root times what?
The inside is the same, so... times 1 over x.
Times 1 over x, Ahsant, plus?
Plus half, mm-hmm. 1 over 2 square root of x.
It is better to say 1 over 2 square root of x times?
Ln x.
Ln x, Ahsant, ya Salim, salamak Allah, mashallah alaik. So this is exactly what Salim said, ya shabab. This is the step that we are done. Now, what is remaining is a matter of simplifying. You need to solve it for y prime, so solve the resulting equation for y prime. So it will be y prime times y, multiply both sides by y, this is y. And now simplify this. It will be 1 over square root of x plus ln x over 2 square root. What is y? You have it from the original expression. So just write it here, and that's it. So this is the best way, Shabab, to differentiate such functions. There is another way, but it depends. It depends on the inverse function property, if you remember. Do you remember, Shabab, that when you have e to the power ln of x, this is equals what?
X.
X.
So you have this. You can write it like this. Do you agree? If you have x, you can write it this way. But we are in fact using this to simplify, not to complicate. So if you have x, you can write it this way. But usually this expression is simpler than this. But in some situations, you need the complicated expressions to help you. Look, we will use it here. You have x to the power square root of x. This x, write it as e to the power ln x. Just like that. Why? Because now I can multiply this by this, the inner and the outer exponent. So this will be e to the power square root of x ln x. Am I right? Now, this is your y. This is y. Now, to find the derivative, you need just to find the derivative of the exponential. Do you remember when you have e to the power g of x, what will be the derivative? Derivative will be what? E to the power g x as it is multiplied by the derivative. So no need here to use the logarithmic differentiation. So now the derivative will be what? The same function as it is, multiplied by the derivative of the power, by the derivative of this. And of course it is the same, here it is. We have it. So this is the idea. The derivative of x square root of x, it will be the derivative of the expression, which is the exponential multiplied by the derivative of the power. And this derivative, we have it from here. Just write it down. And you know that this is just as we said from the beginning, it is x to the power square root of x. So it is the same answer. But of course, we use the work that we did here. So I advise you, Shabak, to use this way. This is the best way to use. But if you want to use that one, it is okay. Now, the last part of this section is about the number E. Do you remember how we defined E? This is not only here, I think in math 002 and also math 101. It is the limit when N goes to infinity for what? For 1 plus 1 over, 1 over N, N to the power N. Do you remember that? We have studied the E to be like this. Or in other way, it is limit X goes to 0. Both this equals to x, 1 plus x, all to the power 1 over x. You can have this way also. Anyway, why? from where this is coming. Can you prove it? This is what we are going to do here. We will prove that E is equal to this limit. So first of all, let's say that our function is ln of x. What is the derivative? 1 over x. What is the value of the function at 1? It is 1. 1 over 1 is 1. Now, we will use this to express E as a limit. How to do that? Do you remember the derivative of the function at 1 according to the chain rule? According to the definition, not according to. The derivative at 1 for a function f, it is the limit when h goes to 0 for f of 1 plus h minus f of 1 h. Is there any problem if I just, instead of h, I will write x? The same. It is just a matter of notation. Now here, this is my function. So this will be what? Ln 1 plus x minus f at 1. What is f at 1? The function f at 1. When x is 1, this will be ln 1. Ln 1, 0. So we will have ln 1 plus x over x. So this is my function, my limit now. This is the derivative at 1. Now, according to the Bauer's rule, ya shabab, can I put this inside? By the Bauer rule of the logarithms, yes. Now what we conclude that the derivative at 1, it is just this one. Ln 1 plus x all to the power 1 over x. Okay, so this means that this equals to what? To f prime at 1. So what is f prime at 1?
1.
So this means that this is equals to 1. This one equals to 1. So here we are. We proved that this equals to 1. Okay? Now, you know that e, it is e to the power 1. Do you agree with me? Now, instead of this one, write this. It will be limit ln 1 plus x. I think we have it here. Let me, because we need to save time. Yes. So it will be e to the power this limit, which is 1. Now, do you remember that when you have limit e to the power g of x, when x goes to a, مثلا, you can write this one as e to the power limit g of x when x goes to a. Why we can do that, shabab? Because the exponential function are what? Continuous. So when the limit exists, when this limit exists, we can do that. Do you remember that from the continuity 2.5? So now I can write the limit here in the power, I can write it here in front of the expression instead of in the exponent. Just I apply this property for the continuous function. Now what I can do, e can be canceled with ln. So we will have limit x goes to 0 for what? For 1 plus x all to the power 1x. What is this? What is this, shabab?
1.
This is, we have proved that e equals this. So what we, to summarize, we have e equals to limit x goes to 0 for 1 plus x all to the power 1 over x. In other words, if you put 1 over x equals to n, this one, put it equals to n, x will be 1 over n. And when x goes to 0, n will go to infinity. Now, you can write this instead of x, 1 over n. Instead of 1 over x, n. So you can have it in two different forms. This is when n goes to infinity, when n x goes to 0. So this is the exponential of 1. طبعاً, if you have here, شباب, e to the power x, لو كانت e to the power x, here instead of this one, you will have x. And you should know that. I think it is better to be added to here. But it is the same. You can just do it here, lock it from here. E to the power x, this will be all to the power x. Okay? So this will be e to the power x, e to the power ln 1, this will be all to the power x. And this x, of course, will be included inside. So this, all of this work will be inside e to the power x. And you will have it at the end repeated x times. So it will be this way. Now, we are done. This is 3.6. These are the some suggested exercise and problems for you to practice. I will give you 2 minutes to solve this exercise. We have here an equation. We need to find the equation of the tangent line for this function at x equals 0. Let me launch a polling for you. طبعا you remember يا شباب how to find the equation of the tangent line. Two minutes يا شباب please to solve this. Oh, during that, let me tell you about the last quiz. I have graded, ya shabab, quiz number 6 finally, alhamdulillah, yesterday. Quiz number 6, it was a written quiz, if you remember. In this quiz, the average is 4.9 out of 10. The maximum is 10, the full mark, 10 out of 10, obtained by one student only. And the minimum is one obtained by one student. And the mode, the most repeated grade is six obtained by eight students. MashaAllah, 9 students can answer the question. MashaAllah, how fast you are. MashaAllah alaykum. Okay, so let me share with you the results so far. MashaAllah, most of you went with C and some of you with A with B. And the right answer is C, you are right. The answer is C. Let's see why the answer is C. طبعاً the idea شباب is here you know what is the derivative of the first of all you need to ask yourself what is the equation of the tangent line. The equation of the tangent line will be y minus y at zero equals to the derivative at zero multiplied by x minus zero. So we need to find y at zero and y derivative at zero. This is the only thing that we need. We have y, so y at zero will be one plus sine, when x is zero, it will be sine zero. Sine zero is zero. To the power zero, zero plus one is one. So it is one. So this one is gone. This is just one. Now we need to find the derivative at zero. So to find the derivative, what we need to do, shabab, we have here a variable to a variable, a function raised to the power of another function. So we need to apply the logarithmic differentiation. So we will take ln of both sides. Ln y equals to, what is the power? The power, write it at the beginning, directly. Ln the base, which is sine 4x. Now to find the derivative, what is the derivative of ln y? Y is a function of x, so the derivative will be y prime over y equals to, to find here the derivative, it will be the first one multiplied by the derivative of ln. So the derivative of this will be 1 plus sine 4x. The derivative of 1 plus sine x, it is 0 plus cosine. It is cosine 4x. And the derivative of 4x is 4. Don't forget to do the chair rule. Plus the second one, which is ln 1 plus sine 4x, multiplied by the derivative of the first one. The derivative of x plus one is one. And we are done now. So y prime will be equals to y times this. Now I want y prime at zero. So I will do it directly. So y prime at zero will be equals to y at zero times. Now both here x equals to zero, what you will have? It will be one times 4 cosine 0 is 1 over 1 plus sine 0 is 0 plus ln 1 plus sine 0 is 0, so it is 1 plus 0. To simplify, what is y at 0? Y at 0 is 1 times, this will be 4 over 1, it will be 4, plus len 1 is 0, so it will be 4 at the end. Now go back to your equation here, so this will be what? This will be 4. Now this will be equals to y equals to 4x plus 1, which is the right answer. Any question, Shabab, here? Let me tell you or give you an idea about all the exam questions. This is a very interesting question, try to solve it. But what I'd like to mention, how to use the logarithmic differentiation. This is all about logarithmic differentiation. Logarithmic differentiation. This is usual product rule. Look here, you need to use, of course, the logarithmic differentiation to simplify. But in some, this is about the limits. You need to remember here that the limit when n goes to infinity for 1 plus 1 over n to the power n is equals to what? Equals to e to the power 1. I told you when you have here k, here it will be k, but here you have 3n here and 3 here. So try to solve it and try to use substitution. I advise you to put this one, for example, equals to m, and you will see how it can be solved. Now look at this. Find the derivative of this one. How many times you need to apply the product rule? Look how much is difficult to find this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, how to apply the product rule. It is so difficult. It will take 1 hour from you to find the derivative of this one. But if you use the logarithmic differentiation, it will be much easier. So the idea is to take ln of both sides. Take ln of both sides. When you take the ln here, ln of the product will be the sum of the lens. So it will be ln this plus, 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 plus. So instead of the product rule, you will use the sum rule. So it will be the derivative of the first plus the derivative of the second plus the derivative and so on. Now you need y prime. So what you will do, you will multiply by y. So y prime will be equals to y times this. Now what is y at 1? You need to find the value of the derivative at 1. What is the value of the derivative at 1? Put here x equals to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and it will be 2 to the power 5. Here it is. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, it will be 2 to the power 5. And here, both x equals 1 here. This is what you are going to have. The same denominator. It will be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. It will be this over 2 to the power 5. So look how easy it is to make the logarithmic differentiation will make our life easier. And you have several problems of this type that you need, like this one. Very complicated function. You need to use the logarithmic differentiation. It will be very easy. This is enough, ya shabab, for 3.6. We will go now to 3.7. By the way, we need to finish 3.10 by this week, by the end of this week. I don't know how we are going to do that, but we will try. Let me share with you now the slides of section 3.7. By the way, 3.7 is very short section. We can finish it let's say 20 minutes. I will do 10 minutes today and 10 minutes in the next class, inshallah. If we have, we don't. Okay, let's introduce you to 3.7. 3.7 is about something that we have mentioned, I think, in 2.7, if I'm not wrong. The rate of change. So in this section, we will mention the rate of change in the natural and social sciences, but we will not do all of that. We will just study the rate of change in physics. This is example one, according to the syllabus. So this section is just, we are going to study only example number one. If you want to study more about the applications, go and do it by yourself, but it will not be included in the exam. Now look, from one example, what we are going to learn. We will going to learn what we mean by the linear motion, the position or the displacement function, how to find the total distance traveled, the velocity, acceleration. By the way, we did most of this before. What is new here is this, how to know that the particle is moving forward in the positive direction or backward in the negative direction. And when it is slowing up, speeding up or slowing down. So let's remember quickly, Shabab. If you have a function, this is the function of the position function or the displacement function. of a particle that is moving on a in a straight line. So we are talking about the linear motion, because we have other types of motions, like the circular motion that you have studied before. But we will focus here on the linear motion. The distance traveled from time t1 to time t2, it will be the absolute value of f of t1 minus f of t1, ft2, because the total distance traveled at the end should be positive. The velocity is the derivative of the displacement function. So it is the rate, it is the rate of change. The acceleration is the rate of change of the velocity with respect to time. So it is the second derivative of the position function, the first derivative of the acceleration. The particle is at rest when the velocity is zero. The particle is moving forward in the positive direction if the velocity is positive. And it moves backward in the negative direction if the velocity is negative. When it is speed up, the particle speeds up when it is pushed in the same direction it is moving. This happens when the velocity is positive and increasing or negative and decreasing, which means that the velocity and the acceleration are both positive or both negative. So to summarize this for you, the particle speeds up when the velocity and the acceleration have the same sign. And they slow down, the particle slows down when they have opposite sign. Example number one. This is the function of the motion of the particle. Find the velocity, just differentiate if you want to find the velocity in general for any time t. Here it is, it is the derivative of this function. Question number two, part B, what is the velocity after 2 seconds and after 4 seconds? But t equals to two here. So it will be v at two. It is negative 3 meters per second. And the velocity at four, it is 9 meters. Look, it could be positive, it could be negative now. It depends, is it moving here? Here it moves backward, here it moves forward in the positive direction or in the negative direction. When the particle is at rest, do you remember we said one when it will be at rest, ya shabab? When what?
The derivative equal to zero.
When what?
The derivative equal to zero.
When v equal to zero.
Derivative of what?
Of the when position the function.
When the velocity is zero. So it be at rest when the velocity is zero. And you remember the velocity, here is the velocity. So the velocity will be equal to zero. This is quadratic equation, solve it, factor. T equals to one or T equals to three. So the particle will be at rest after 1 second, after 1 second and also after 3 seconds. When is the particle moving forward, the positive direction? When? When the velocity is what?
Is positive.
Is certainly positive, non-negative. When it is strictly greater than zero. So now you will solve an equality. So you need to solve this inequality. Factor it, we have factored in the previous slide. This is the factorization. Now you need to make a table of values for one and three. Here you will put t minus one, t minus three. It will be طبعا here, negative, positive, positive, then negative, negative, positive. And in total after that, the product of them will be at the end positive, negative, positive. So it will be positive here. I think I put it, yes, I put it for you here, by the way. I forgot, this is not in your book. I put it by myself for you. Now, this is when it is, of course, positive. It will be in the positive direction moving forward. And of course, when it is negative, it moves backward. So this will summarize the velocity when it is moves backward and forward. Draw a diagram to represent the motion of the particle. So we know when it is moving forward and backward. So we can draw the diagram. So this is the diagram. So this is the time when the time is zero. So what happens from second number one, from when the time is what, zero and to 1 second? It moves, of course, from here to here, it moves forward. This is forward. Unfortunately, the time is up. We will continue that inshallah next class. See you then, inshallah. If you have any questions, I have 1 minute for you before I go to the another section that I have.
شكرا يا دكتور.
يعافيكم شباب بالتوفيق إن شاء الله.
شكرا يا دكتور.
العفو.